After tonight,
you may regret changing your date. I see a lot of familiar faces out there, and the disadvantage is these people in the Hosky have never heard any of these stories before. So if you've heard any of these stories, Harry Bridges or Jimmy Williams, Governor Miller, go ahead and laugh anyway. It'll make me feel better. I'm actually going to play in a Hosky. I'm going to share a few tales with you all tonight. Gwen mentioned going out to the Country Music Awards in Nashville, and I remember the first trip I made out there. It's been about 6 years ago. It doesn't seem like it's been that long, but it's been a while. My sister went with us, Linda Sawyer. Some of you may know her. She works over at the bank in Manio. She'd never been out of town, much less on an airplane. She was quite apprehensive about the whole trip, to be quite honest. And we got on, 64 Interstate through Norfolk, and saw the sign for the airport there, and we turned off on the exit, and riding along, she began to just scream and shake, and I said, "What's the problem?" And she pointed out to a sign that said, "Terminal Building." I tried to explain to her. I said, "You don't have anything to worry about. That's just where they're going to unload the passengers and load the passengers." We calmed her down a little bit, got her on the airplane, and started taxiing out to the runway to take off. And the stewardess began explaining what to do in the event that the plane should crash. Now, this bothered her quite a bit, too. She said, "Now, when this mass comes down from the ceiling, that means there's a hole in the cockpit." Well, at that point, sister reached up and grabbed the chair in front and started shaking. The only bad thing, she had the hair of the woman in that chair at the same time. We had to pry her hands off. She had a death grip. She began to explain how the seatbelt worked, and then she went into the part about the life-saving cushion. That is your life preserver in the event you go down in the water. You all have heard that, I'm sure. Sister looked over at me. She said, "How much water is there between Norfolk and Nashville?" I said, "Not much." She said, "I don't want a cushion that'll float. I want one that'll bounce me up out of a cornfield." At that point, she began to move towards the back of the plane. I said, "Where are you going?" She said, "I have never seen them back one of these into a mountain." Finally, we got out to Nashville. I was paying for everything. Got us a great motel room. It was $19.95. Now, I know it's a cheap sleep. I understand that. Got signing in, and while I was signing in, a bed bug crawled across the registration book. That's the first time I've ever had one look to see which room I was staying in. Anyway, we got on down there to the motel, went in the room, and I knew right away I was in the presidential suite because I could tell by all the jelly beans and the peanuts laying around in the floor. You can imagine for 1995, it was not a big room. You've seen them small ones. You got to slide into the shower. You know, John.
Yeah.
Have you ever backed out of a hot shower into a cold brass doorknob with the key still in it? Come a knock on the door. Lady said, "This is a maid." I said, "Whatever you do, woman, don't turn that doorknob." Anyway. As most of you know, I came from a poor family money-wise, but we were certainly rich in love. We didn't have an awful lot. We couldn't even afford a dog. We heard a sound at night. The kids would take turns going to the door and barking. We all slept in the same bed, all the kids. I never slept alone until I got married. My grandmother was a very special lady. Some of you may have known her. She came from Texas, and she was just always full of love and caring for all of us. You could never do anything wrong. I remember once she was sick in the hospital, and I went to visit with her, and I stayed a couple of hours, and she had a little bowl of peanuts there, and through the course of that visit, I ate every one of her peanuts. I realized I'd done it. I said, "Granny, I'm so sorry. I've eaten all your peanuts. I'll get you some more." "No," she said, "don't do it." Didn't have any teeth. She said, "Don't worry about it. It's all right." That's the way she was. She says, "I've already sucked all the chocolate off of them." You need to explain that to him back there in the green shirt. He didn't quite get that. The fellow in the white shirt got it.